Hey, this is Alpha. 10 days ago, Anthropic released the Model Context Protocol, or MCP for short. If you are a million-dollar brand, here is everything you should know to use this protocol today. I'll dive into the announcement, but first I want to spotlight a post on X by Alex, who is the head of cloud relations. He describes MCP quite nicely, and so I'll give him credit here. It is an open standard that aims to empower the agentic AI community to connect agents with data. The problem that MCP solves is that every developer, and I'll dive into this further on as I move on through this Twitter thread, is building custom integrations for every single data source they're connecting their agents to. And MCP aims to standardize that, and MCP aims to create a consistent way of allowing large language model apps or agents to connect to data. So let's dive into that. So through the Twitter thread here, Alex describes that you can connect Claude through MCP to a source like GitHub, which of course is a code repository, allow that agent to create a new repository and then make a pull request through this MCP model context protocol. And of course, once the integration is set up, in this case on Claude desktop, and I'll talk more about that, you're able to then set up this entire system in less than 1 hour. So if I do a quick screen share here and I just perhaps do a full screen, I should be able to show you what that looks like. So here you have an individual who starts asking an agent to respond. And then in here, you see the artifacts coming back and showing that it's the creation of the repository is done through a tool use. You have updating of files, pushing the files. Once a user confirms through this model here, now that agent is now able to make autonomous decisions on the user's behalf. In this case, Alex is creating a new issue on GitHub through this MCP server. And when it's done, this entire workflow is essentially creating a new page. In this case, it's HTML. It's pushing that page onto GitHub. And if I just skip to the very end of this video, you're gonna see what that looks like. So there's that HTML that was created by this agent. It's a simple page, of course, but it's showing the potential of this agent in its ability to understand the data that it's dealing with. In this case, it's GitHub, and it's able to use tools to interact with GitHub on users' behalf. So if I scroll down, quickly run through kind of the justification for going down this path for Anthropic. Today, Alex says, every developer needs to write custom code to connect agents to data sources. It is definitely messy and repetitive because there's consistency across authentication layers, there's consistency across data handling, data privacy, structured data. All of that glue code, as I call, is necessary for every single project that an AI agent needs to be able to interact with third-party data. And the MCP aims to really share a few common problems through offering at least three or more primitives or components. First is resources, second is tools, third is prompts, and I'll dive into that as I touch on the documentation here. If I scroll down, we do see their implementation. It's nothing more than a client-server architecture where the client, in this case, an AI agent, is connecting to a server, or and that server is now connecting to a resource, whether it's local or whether it's public and remote through an API. So in this case, an AI agent is talking to GitHub through this MCP server. If I scroll down, we see that MCPs are able to accommodate for two circumstances. One is local data, and the second is remote data. You can see that here, local resources, as it's called here, is the equivalent of a local knowledge base that includes database or any kind of access to local files, whether it's text files, markdown files, or code. And remote data is nothing more than third-party data like Slack or GitHub. And of course, this is not, we're not limited to these two. There's an abundance of APIs you can connect your agents to. If we scroll down here, essentially, we do see those primitives jump up here again. The resource that I mentioned, that includes everything that is equivalent of a knowledge base. Tools are essentially actions that the agent takes, and prompts, and this is quite unique here, I want to give credit to where it's due here. Anthropic released prompts, but this should be really called prompt templates. And I think this is going to be an evolution of how humans interact with agents, or how human in the loop workflows can improve the outcomes. So if we scroll down here, quickly touch on the other aspects of this announcement. Security is a big one, and these servers are secure by design. And that's because they do not share API keys with the large language model providers like OpenAI, Anthropic, etc. And that's because when a user is interacting with an MCP or an MCP server, they're not copying and pasting their API keys. So a user who wants to integrate with their GitHub account is not going into GitHub, copying that key, pasting it into Claude. For that reason, security is baked in. If we scroll down, we're gonna quickly run through the rest of the post that Alex has made in this thread. Of course, MCP can run locally. These servers are running on local machines. And of course, they are supporting third-party servers, and I'll show you what that looks like through code examples. But for now, they're definitely enterprise friendly. And so if you are an enterprise and you want to use an MCP, it's possible. And the security is something that's available from day zero. If we look at their motivation, we see that essentially we are living in an agentic world where AI or AI agents connect to any data source through a single elegant protocol. Of course, this is their vision, this is their aspiration, but I believe that it aligns with the way I see the world, which is that if you are a $1 million brand and you want to go to the next level, you need to use AI agents, you need to use AI assistants, or sometimes referred to as virtual assistants, to get there faster. MCP is, from this analogy, is nothing more than a universal translator between the assistant and the tools, the knowledge bases, and all of the available templates that can arise as you develop agents. If we scroll through, just to make sure we spotlight everything that Alex says here, the getting started guide is less than 5 minutes, and I'll show you what that looks like. And beyond that, the true motivation here is to accomplish what Microsoft has done many years in the past. And that is, when they released LSP for integrated development environments, Microsoft had really standardized a way to have coding environments pull data from local files. And in a similar way, the Anthropic team is aiming to use the Model Context Protocol to create an open standard for all of large language model interactions. Very, very optimistic, very altruistic, but I think this is a great way to go about it because it's open source. If we look at the rest of the links here, Alex spotlights all of the major announcements and the associated announcement links for that. And the last piece I'll mention here is that I think is quite interesting yet new, and that is, you can then take the entire source code, rather the documentation of MCP, and then you can feed this entire document, which you can see is a very large markdown file that Anthropic team has put together. It's accessible at modelcontextprotocol.io/llms-full.txt. On this link, you'll be able to essentially see a single file that represents the entire documentation for MCP. And this is quite useful if you are using agents yourself to interact with MCP documentation, to implement MCP servers, and I'll show you what that looks like in a bit. So if we dive into the how-to, to get started, it's really simple. You download the desktop application. Keep in mind, it's in beta today, so you do expect some bugs, whether it's a Mac or a Windows operating system. Once you've installed it, you then really run through the quick start guide, and this is the less than 5 minute guide that Alex mentioned. Once you get the Claude application and you are now following a tutorial, or you're setting up an existing server, in this case, the quick start focuses on setting up a local database, connecting that agent to that database, and then being able to answer questions that a user may have about that data. So in this case, if I skim to the bottom here, we can see that the server is connecting to a local database stored in .db file through SQLite. And on the bottom, once you have the connection established, once you've spun up the MCP server, you can have a user ask a question. Hey, can you connect to my database and tell me what procs are available? Now, this would require an SQL query because we're dealing with SQL syntax in order to extract that data. But the interesting part is that because this is an agent, because it has learned what SQLite database looks like, and it has a tool to be able to interact with it, it's able to create the query and then describe the tables, list available resources, and give you back a response. And of course, the Anthropic team dives deeper into how that works. But I want to really spotlight a couple of things that are important. If you are a brand and you want to get started, definitely follow this quick start guide. But the Anthropic team has also released several open source repositories, which will make it very easy for you to get started. First is servers. And if we refresh, we do see that the servers list is always updated to the latest and greatest. If we dive into the source folder, you see every single implementation that is already available today that you can use. So that means you don't need to write any code. You can just rely on these existing MCP servers to get started. So one of my favorites is Brave Search. So if you want to, for example, have an agent go online, perform research, come back with the findings, write reports for you, then you simply need the Brave Search engine or this server to be able to give you that type of response. And of course, this server is doing nothing more than an internet search. So what you can expect is this agent now is going to learn two new tools. First is Brave Search, and second is Brave Local Search. One is used for general querying of Brave browser. Second is used to perform local search on the Brave browser. So this is great for finding local businesses and services. And to set this up, it's as simple as getting the Brave Search API key, which they do have a free account if you are performing less than 2,000 queries a month. So 2,000 queries a month, if we do the math here, it's more than 66 queries per day. So this is more than enough for you to try, test, and see if it applies to your workflows. Once you've developed this specific workflow, you will understand whether or not you should pay for a different plan on Brave. And of course, once you have the key, you're now using this instruction to be able to set up Claude in a way that makes sense for you. So you simply need to open this file on your computer, and there's instructions and documentation how to do so. Once you have entered your Brave API key here, you will be able to use this Brave Search server to empower the agent to now use these two new tools, Brave Search and Brave Local Search. Once you have this agent using these tools, it will now be able to perform research on your behalf. So the agent will go online, it'll ask you your permission, it will perform search, and it will come back with the results. So if I dive into the other three repositories, I think you'll have a better understanding of the potential of this project. So this is the official Python SDK. And of course, the TypeScript SDK that Anthropic released. This is great if you are dealing with either TypeScript or Python code bases. In either case, you can build MCP clients, you can create servers, you can use different standard protocols for transportation, and all of that is managed through either Python or TypeScript. The last piece I'll mention here is the inspector, and this is great if you want to start testing your server, and this is a great visual tool that allows you to do so. The interface looks like so, and you have the inspector, which opens up a local application on your computer. You're able to connect to a server with a command, just like what we saw before, and you're able to test various aspects. That includes if a server has any resources, it'll show up here. If you have defined any templates or prompts, they will show up here, or any other tooling, you'll be able to test with the server in a very convenient fashion. So it's just a matter of running a simple script. If you copy this command and you paste it, now you should be able to use this specific inspector or more of a debugging tool. So to come full circle, now we are in a moment in time when MCP allows any brand to quickly deploy agents that are grounded in private and public knowledge bases. We're at a point where developers who are interested to go agentic are able to empower their agents with the necessary tools, with the necessary knowledge bases, with the necessary template to go to the next level. And if you find this interesting, if you want to see more content like this, I will be creating other content for brands so they can get up to speed on the latest and greatest. If you're interested to see more content from me, please hit the subscribe button and get notified the next time I post a video like this. I really appreciate your time. Until next time.